You're doing great.
I tried for you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are on our last harumph. Slancha.
Slancha.
Honestly, to a great first episode ever.
You're welcome.
Slancha.
Get your hand off my penis!
Why
don't
you just have to keep it in the
book?
You want to suck a dick?
I don't care. Why the fucking lying?
English, motherfucker! Do you speak it?
That's nasty.
Okay, okay.
Welcome to Keep It in the Fucking Tacos premiere episode. Holy fuck. You have no idea how fucking hard it's taken us to even get to this point.
Thank you, Reposado 1800.
Yes, I mean, as you can see, we've already clearly fucking started this episode without the cameras. Huh? So, first off, we have Lit-Tits over here, who's an awesome hasher within the community. Daddy. We'll get to her in a bit. But first, we're gonna go ahead and let Keep It in the Guac spew his fucking nonsense. Hey guys, Keep It in the Guac here. So I'm gonna give you all two rules to live by.
One.
Don't stick your dick in the fucking turkey, no matter how many times your friends fucking tell you to do it.
That's nasty.
I don't care how drunk you guys are, it's never a good idea.
Number two.
If you're gonna steal a dog, make sure the dog is in a completely different neighborhood away from you.
It helps.
And number three, there's three things you don't fuck with. Another man's money, another man's woman,
or another man's guacamole.
Or else the man fucks with you. Alright, good luck out there. Now that you're all fucking well edumacated, we're gonna go ahead and jump straight into this. So Lit-Tits, could you please provide us with your name, how you got named, in 2 minutes or less?
I was traveling alone for 7 days in Saipan in the Northern Mariana Islands, and I always looked for the hash. I heard about the hash for about a year, and somehow the hash found me. A gay guy I became really friends with, he says, "Hey girl!" I was day drinking at like a beach tiki bar, blah, blah, blah. And he said, "Do you wanna go on a hike?" And I was like, day drinking, like, not really, you know, but I was sitting by myself and I was like, eh, maybe I'll meet new friends. Okay, cool. Next thing you know, I realized, oh my God, this is the thing I've always heard of that I've been trying to find. Find the kennel, we're hiking through the jungle. It's hot as balls. I almost died. We went into an old World War II cave / bunker, had my phone in my bra and the flashlight went off and the whole pitch black thing just went, the whole cave just went lit up. Everybody got a huge kick out of it, made fun of me. Circle came. I got named Lit-Tits because of that. Then I got on a plane right after and I flew back to South Korea.
Border jumpers, you guys need to go ahead and pep your fucking game up. They're going to like fucking caves and castles and monuments.
Oh my God.
And shit.
It was intense. It was intense. That's I thought fucking, I was gonna die.
I mean, you're well traveled.
A little bit.
Just a wee bit. All right. So that we'll go ahead and start off by taking our first shot. Slush.
Okay.
Oh God.
Cheers. That was delicious.
It was very fucking tasty. So. Phase two.
A few moments later.
Genitalia.
Fuck you, camera.
At what age did you first inspect your vagina? And how did you feel about it?
Say probably 9 or 10, I think.
9 or 10 years old.
If I had to guess, I mean, it was a long time ago.
That is very fucking young.
And I mean, I bet it felt great. I don't know. I mean, what do you do at 9 or 10?
You're supposed to be playing with toys and shit, you know? Not like scrummaging through your fucking vagina. Like.
I'm an old soul.
Did you have like a pencil or something to shove in there?
No,
like,
I didn't put anything
like
up there.
Like a ruler to see like how how far did this go?
When did you jerk off first? Has to be younger than that.
I humped the couch. It was completely different. Oh, bop it.
Unfortunately not.
No?
I did have one of those though. Oh
on
my
your
God.
Vagina?
I did. No, like that's I did impressive. Have one of those toys though. They were awesome. Good. That would have been a good idea if I thought of it at 9 or 10 though.
Bop it.
Twist it. What's the other one? Pull it.
Those sick fucking toy makers.
So we all made it.
So have you named your vagina yet?
No.
I
didn't know many vaginas had names.
Your husband's like right over there. You haven't fucking named her
Wait,
vagina.
Wait, he is? Wait, he is?
It's like sacrilegious.
He's not supposed to be here.
He's just looking like
Guac, he's not supposed to be here though.
He fucking crept in somehow.
Just kidding.
He's like hiding behind a fucking couch and shit like
up.
What about my wife's vagina? Huh? So alright, so if you could go ahead and give 3 adjectives for your vagina, what would it be?
Well, if it comes to pussy, we gotta keep it with 3 P's, right?
3 P's.
So let's see. Pink?
Okay.
I'd
be worried if it wasn't.
Right?
And we're like not, fucking we're not. Blue. I got blue waffle up in here.
Let's see. I don't know. 3 P's. Pink, Pretty, and Perfect.
Pink, Pretty, and Perfect. I think with that, we can go ahead and create a pussy hash name. Oh, husband, yes, are you Daddy. Watching me watch her? That's the rules of assignment for engagement for tonight.
But maybe you could just name it. It'd probably be hilarious.
Bruh.
Maybe by the end of the night with enough fucking tequilas, we'll have some fucked up name.
We are doing
it. All right, round three, which is a dual round.
Dun, dun, dun.
All right, so we're going to be playing two truths and a lie. So one, I used to jump out of airplanes for a lift. Two, I used to date a girl with a wooden leg. And
sorry, that's not funny. Keela, blame this, guys. Blame this.
And three, I used to own a 1965 Volkswagen Beetle.
That's hard. I feel like you would totally date somebody with a wooden leg. I know you jumped out of airplanes. So I would say that's probably your favorite car or some bullshit, but you didn't own a 65 Beetle.
You're wrong.
Ah! Damn. I lose. All right, I lose. Cheers.
Slanted.
Cheers.
All right. You're two truths and a lie.
Climbed a volcano in California. I swam with sharks. Or I skydived in Saipan.
You didn't swim with sharks?
No, I totally did.
Alright, well, fuck me.
I swam with whale sharks in the Philippines.
Alright, so number four.
Right.
This category, under government. What would you do if tomorrow you woke up and porn was the main sense of currency?
I mean, I guess we all have to do porn, right?
What would be your number one position? Like, what would be the moneymaker position?
Oh dear. I mean, does it have to be a legit name?
I mean, I'm sure everyone have to have like their own little moneymaker, you know, the rock what your mama gave
you. I mean, I guess I would just do porn, let dude slam me up against a wall or bend me over. I'm still a little bit flexible from being a gymnast for 20 years.
You're still a bit flexible? See, spread that 20, spread the 20. Come on, let's get the 90. 90. Okay, we got it.
Right. Maybe handstand.
What would be the equivalent to like nugget porn?
I don't understand.
Oh dear, nugget porn. Why don't you explain that one?
We're nugget porn. The rest of the porn society is like, don't bring that shit up.
I've seen some pretty nasty porn, dude.
Well, this is pretty fucking even awkward, too. Like, it's even weird to watch. Like, nugget porn is a like amputee with no arms, no legs.
I've totally seen it.
And it's just like, it's a fucking nugget with a hit. Like, I would feel bad, like, if I was on top. But, I mean, my question would be, like, what the fuck is the currency for that? Like...
I've totally seen. I didn't know that that's what it was called. I will be honest, but I've totally seen it because it's my whole life. No, I didn't even was not even turned on. And if somebody is, I am very sorry for you.
Very sorry for you.
Way worse than foot fetish.
Oh yes, way worse than foot fetish.
I need the money. I need to pay rent.
At least watching porn. At least watching that porn is. They're not gonna get my money for that.
So which would be worth more, gay porn or lesbian porn?
Oh my god, lesbian porn, of course.
Lesbian porn would be worth more?
Than gay porn? Of course!
Why would that be the case?
Because don't they say that when guys first enter porn that they have to do gay porn whether they're gay or not, so half the time they don't even have a chub? Or a hard-on.
Sounds to me like the gay guys would need more, like they would get paid more.
And who came up with the word twink for gay guys?
Huh?
For real.
Twink?
That's like the worst word.
See, I'm gonna switch it. Like, I have no idea what a twink is.
Really? And you've watched how much porn?
Twink? I've heard twink. Twink yeah. Or twink?
Twink.
Twink, because that's like a bottom, like a submissive or something, right?
Huh?
Well, it's just like a right? gay, it's just a gay guy that takes
no.
it.
No, it's a young boy, younger male,
like,
young, hairless.
Yeah, yeah.
Like a young little Asian boy.
Why do you have to be Asian?
Because how many Asians do you see with facial hair or any hair? Asians are like hairless.
Well, I mean, whoever came up with that word, I'm straight. But even gay or lesbian porn can be hot to anybody, I'm sure, right?
I mean,
but
I've watched tranny porn.
Right? But, no. But some of the words
and
that
I
they...
finished.
Some of the words they come up with is just like...
What would you say, like, Jaden Smith's worth would be in the porn currency?
Who's Jaden Smith?
I guess that answers that fucking question. It's Will Smith's son.
Oh, I know who he is.
All right, so number five.
When are we doing another shot? I'm getting thirsty.
Oh, that's absolutely, you're absolutely right.
I mean, we've still been got fucking two, slacking three, this, though, haven't we? I know.
Actually,
we gotta do number two.
We need to catch the fuck up here.
We gotta do number two.
Number two, tree, four, yeah. All right.
Tree.
Two, number three.
Forest. There you go.
Is it good though?
Yeah, I mean, is it?
Because not all hot sauces are good.
Oh no, this hot sauce is good. It's very simple, but it is good. It's not like Louisiana and butter or some bullshit.
Cheers. Slancha.
I apologize for the next person that has to do this with guac, but it is a great time.
So, all right, let's say
namaste.
Tomorrow, you find out you got 5 years to fucking live. That's it, and then you're fucking dead. But You're given $1 million. What are you doing with that 5 years of lifespan? That's it.
Well, if it's only $1 million, it's not gonna last very long. If I know I'm gonna die.
Jesus Christ, what the fuck are you doing with that $1 million?
Well, I would give...
$1 million is a lot of money.
No, I really would. I would give... I mean, it's really not...
cocaine!
I mean... Well... No, I'm just kidding.
We're gonna go to Juarez, we're gonna find her as soy jefe. You better buy the Kentucky Club, alright?
Oh, I love the Kentucky Club.
And then me and Strawberry are just gonna go fucking get naked there, like, every day.
Perfect. Will you guys be my male strippers?
Oh yeah, better damn well believe it.
Oh,
what else?
No, I mean, I would give a little bit to those I love to pay off what they need to pay off. I'd be debt-free and to not be boring, but then I would just take the rest and I would travel the world until I ran out of money. And then I guess I would just like live my life around my family and I would hash till the day I died.
So you would just like, all right, so you would stay in like the nice hotels.
No, absolutely not.
You'd say like, Guac, you're now my like, you know, adopted brother. We're traveling the world.
I mean, yeah, if you want to come.
We have time. I'm coming everywhere.
It's only one. It's only $1 million.
That's
I mean,
a lot of money. Do you
realize? $1 million today is not that much money. You've probably spent well over $1 million in your adulthood.
No, I probably like maybe in the 200,000s and shit like that. I'm a broke bitch.
I'm a broke bitch too.
I was not born into royalty.
I wasn't born into royalty. But no, I would not stay in luxury places. I would not stay.
Well, that's how you're gonna blow $1 million like that.
Like that. No.
You got that fucking
hostels are where it's at, guys. Don't be afraid of that movie. Unless I would take like 60,000 probably and pay to climb Mount Everest in Kathmandu.
You'd like, be one of those people.
Like just as quick as I can do it, though.
So you'd wait,
actually,
like, on
do you want to know what I would do?
Fourth year.
Do you want to know what I would do?
364th day.
Yeah, and just leave me on the top of the mountain with all the other dead bodies. Like, where else? I don't want to be burned. If anybody ever burns me or cremates me when I die, I will haunt you for the rest of my life. I spent so many years trying not to get burned. Nobody better cremate me.
I want to be an avocado tree.
Right? See? I'm going to freeze and rot away anyways. It doesn't matter whether I'm in the ground or not. At least I'd be somewhere beautiful, right? It's all about life. You only live once.
YOLO. Next one. Round 6 is try to make me laugh, which is, of course, a dual round. We'll go ahead and let you start. I should have just fucking flipped the motherfucker and I would have just won that one.
I really did not know how to like make you laugh because you always, for the most part, I've always seen you smiling. And so I asked a couple other hashers and a couple other people, I'm like, how would I make him go Guac and keep it together? No matter how many shots of tequila you do, but you always have a smile on your face. So what is a smile or what is a laugh to you? And everybody told me, yeah, good luck. Just take the loss, bitch. Oh, but I just made you laugh, so I guess it's a double fucking loss.
Is that
just chuckled. Double loss.
Oh, no, that was politeness. But all right, fine. Fuck it. I'll take it.
Oh, no. I have to drink. You know what? I spent the day with some of my favorite hashers. Don't worry. We were social distancing. I don't want anybody jumping down our throat.
I was in everybody's faces.
I haven't seen certain people.
How do you feel about that?
In months, and today was a great day. So I guess we're just gonna take the loss on this one because I think we're already giggling and laughing and having a great time. So
we have had a great fucking day.
Yes, we did have a great day.
Gotta go to downtown El Paso, which I have not gone to since I've been back in El Paso.
Me neither, since I've been back from some things out of town. Yeah.
No. We'll get there. We're going to hell in style. Bring the chariot.
We're with all this tequila, I feel like we're just washing the sins out of our mouths right now.
Yeah, good luck with that one too. Round 7. I don't know if you watch cartoons. Or
Archer.
So which of the cartoon characters, or in this case, will even allow celebrities? Have you ever had dirty thoughts, you know, finger banged yourself thinking about?
Cartoon, no, other than Archer. The cartoon, he is, or whatever, animation, he is,
so
he's
never
a
had
special
like
agent.
You've never gotten like, kind of like, you know?
Little over animation, no.
Clip boner?
Over animation.
Jesus, I'm like, am I
I'm sorry, I mean, I guess I'm not that interesting, I don't know.
No,
I maybe mean, I don't have. Maybe I don't have that bright of an imagination.
Maybe you just weren't looking at Esmeralda from Hunchback of Notre Dame the way I was. Or even it even got worse, was like fucking Lion King, and then Nala, when he pounced on her, I was like, get her.
Okay, one cartoon character I could think of for going on movies and stuff, Aladdin.
So you looked at Aladdin and you were like,
you like rescued a princess. Who doesn't want to be rescued? I mean, he was like a, so that's pretty hot. And he was like good looking in the movie and came from nothing to everything and married the princess.
Prince of Babwa, and the biggest dick right? in the Southwest.
Right? But it's a fairy tale.
And I have a camel.
And he has a monkey too.
And a monkey.
That does everything for
Pet
him.
Pet my fucking monkey. Pet it, no really. All right, well, I mean, so is there any other like, character?
Actor I have the hots for? Oh my God. The things I would do to Taylor Kinney.
Have you ever, like, pictured Taylor Kinney's face, like, over your husband when you're having sex with him?
Yes, you know what? I have. I mean, that's totally uncomfortable.
I don't think you even need an answer after the...
But he always told me that we would get one free pass for our celebrity crush. So next one.
All right, number eight. Number eight is.
Wait, don't we have to do one? Oh two, yes, you're three, absolutely four, right. Five. We're only on six.
Give it to me.
Okay.
Give me your stone cold
bam,
best
bam,
shot.
Bam, bam, bam. You've just been stunned.
Slant
bitch.
It.
Okay. All right. Cheers.
Number eight, would you rather? Now.
I'm getting nervous. These questions are getting like.
So, would you rather have chlamydia or herpes?
What? What kind of question is that? Neither, but herpes is like pretty much everybody on the planet has a form of herpes. So I guess herpes, but they both can be cured. So what does it matter?
Herpes cannot be cured, but you are right that everybody on the fucking planet
is it.
Right.
So do I want to be like everybody else, or do I want to be a leader and just be cured?
You want to be? I like the attitude.
Right?
Leader, like, master of chlamydia.
I mean, you know what? Like the, you know what I mean. So I mean, I already picked. I mean, I guess herpes, because everybody has a form of it.
So, cocaine or ecstasy?
What you doing?
Oh my God, that is such a hard decision. A very hard decision.
Like even strawberry over there was like.
and Chris is going, hope your mother doesn't see this. Please. I would say cocaine. First ever tried ecstasy, like way back in the day. They said, you have to drink a ton of water. And I actually know somebody that died from it.
But I understood that ecstasy, you don't know what's actually in it.
It could be laced with heroin. It could be laced with...
Chlamydia.
Yeah, it could be laced with chlamydia, herpes. But back in the day, they used to tell us...
It would put holes in your head.
Holes in your brain.
That's what
stuff.
I understood also.
So I would actually wait the time frame.
I think we're good. My last hole is filled. Becky,
anyways.
Bring it out.
So even though coke hurts your nose, I don't think it's going to give you... It might hurt your heart, but you need that to live. But coke, I mean, you need your brain in it. You don't want to be brain dead. Nope. That's why it's a hard decision. I don't tell anybody what to do.
Grade A U.S. of A right there. Wait, as I'm also coming to go ahead and realize, one, two, three, no.
I know, that's
so we're missing, like, we need to catch up.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
This is a hard part to fucking drink, and we keep fucking this shit up.
I know, no, but record it, because we already did this earlier, because we fucked it
recording.
Up. Oh, that was just...
We're on the record now.
Oh, all right. How do you say it in Gaelic?
Slancha.
Slancha.
Slancha means good health.
What means cheers in Gaelic?
Cheers.
Give me a Guinness, bitches. As bad as I
is this the final hour?
Ready? Set? Cilantro.
Alright, so weird. Now, number nine. Let's see if we get it wrong or right.
Get ready. The thing in between your butthole and your vagina.
A scrotum.
On a female or a male. The thing in between your dick and your butthole. A little piece of shit in between your butthole. What's the skin called in between your butthole? Guac.
Gucci.
Guac. Really? The thing in between your butthole
vaginas.
And your dick. The thing in between. Next. Have you never heard of taint? What? That's what it's called. Oh God! What everybody in the government bitches about? If the ozone's coming down, the government wants to think they're gonna fix it, but they're not. But everybody's like. If we get the next ice age, what is it called? It's gonna be blamed on
gay pride. You said the fucking government.
Global warming, next. Oh dear. What? Look at Strawberry. What is that called?
Booty.
What is he, the dance move?
Shake your ass, shake your ass, shake your ass.
What does women do when they shake
twerk.
Their butt? Yet, yes, twerking.
Oh shit, I'm losing this one.
You're losing, when your dick's hard through your pants, what's it called?
Erection. Chlamydia.
Your
virginity.
Hard, your dick's hard through your pants. You have a
spasm.
No, you have a
bulge.
Bulge, yes.
Oh my God.
You're not very good at this. You're not very good at this.
Thank you very much. I'll be here all now.
You, I thought I did pretty good.
Jesus, she used to be a porn star, but now she's an actress, and she played in the role of Friends.
Pamela Anderson.
No, Friends.
I don't know what the real names are.
Friends, and she was. She
I don't know what the real names.
She
are.
Plays a lot of roles.
Next, I don't know what the real names are. I don't know. When who was
you,
it?
When you, it was a show. Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Aniston. I was just gonna say Jennifer Aniston.
So you want to go ahead and sell shit, and it's on a TV show.
QVC.
But at a store that normally takes in shit.
Amazon.
No. It's a store. It's a show. It's
oh
a
my
show.
God! Like the 40-year-old virgin.
No. Yes. Quite enough. But not really. It's a store, but they're trying to buy shit at a, you know, at a store on a TV show, and he's like, oh, I'll give you this much for it.
Pawn shop.
You suck.
Fuck it. Close enough.
Okay.
What you find whenever me and Strawberry go to Mexico.
Whatever you find, that doesn't narrow it down.
We go to Kentucky Club and we're like, hey, how much you
hookers, need? Strippers, prostitutes.
No, so we want to go ahead and find some
cocaine.
Yeah, but who? No.
Strats.
No, okay. Cartel. Interspecies erotica.
What?
Whenever you have sex with an animal.
I don't remember what that's called right now.
Bestiality. So you're blind, but you. Oh yeah, I can't say that, right? Physically blind, visibly, but you're on a date with someone.
You are not good at this game. I can't even do this right now. You are okay, that's it. You are horrible at this game.
Oh,
like, sorry, blind people. If you can see or you can't, it's a blind. Oh my god, it's so hot in here, and I turned the AC down like 7 times.
Okay, I guess that counts as one, right? That's it. All right, so we survived that round. Nine. Nine. Done. All right. Let's take that shot.
I'm doing better than I thought I was going to do. I mean, I'm not that Slunch drunk. Up. Okay. Shit. Oh, wait. Do you want sauce?
This is where the show starts turning to shit, ladies and gentlemen. Round 10. So, ladies and gentlemen, the thing about round 10 is...
Should we stretch?
Yes. Go ahead. Do your little butthole stretches. I went ahead and brewed my own concoction of...
Wait, but we have
jalapeno tequila.
Come here, lean into me. Lean into me. You got guac in your guac beer.
So, number 10, the last and final round. I want you to go ahead and tell us what the fuck happened about you getting detained when you're coming back from fucking Thailand and the whole Juarez experience? What the hell got you arrested?
That's your number 10 question.
In fact, we could go and take the shot for it.
Where's mine? We're doing it first?
Do this first.
Okay.
Cilantro.
Cilantro. I bought the house here in EP. Thank you everybody for being so kind to me and welcoming me into your community. Now I'm slurring and now you're gonna make me tell this story. You're a jerk. Long story short, COVID hits and I flew through Beijing. No,
huh?
I'm sorry, I flew through Shanghai.
Huh?
I came back from Thailand. I was detained in New York City. Then I was detained in Texas.
Wait, you were detained in New York City and then back in Texas?
By the CDC, yes. I was detained. They took my phone. They took all of my credentials. They took my passport. They took all of my IDs. They took everything. I had nothing.
Like, you were a prostitute in 6 states. Did you know that?
Right? And I sat at the border for over an hour. And it was during winter. And... Hey, if you ever need a good friend, Strawberry is a good friend. He didn't even know what was going on, and I raised hell. I was like, can somebody please just tell my friend outside on the American side? He already had walked over.
Like, so little innocent Strawberry is just shivering in the fucking cold like correct. A poor little wanderer.
The majority of people would have left anybody, because God knows how many hours it would take.
Strawberries don't belong in the cold.
No,
they get shriveled up. Have you seen strawberry little testicles in the cold? It's not pretty. So it sounds to me like you have yourself a great fucking friend.
I do.
And he comes in a form of a strawberry.
And he does.
All right, so without else to do or say, we're going to end this last and final episode of the first ever premiere episode of Keeping the Fuackin Taco with a shot that is infused with jalapenos that is brewed by yours truly. So, with that being said, I fucking love you, love. Thank you so much for being a part of my first ever show.
Hey, you know what? I'm so happy to be a part of it, and I'm so proud of you, and you're gonna go a million miles with us.
We're all gonna go, we're all gonna succeed. Cause Hashers, we ride together.
Exactly.
Ride or die, bitches.
Ride or die.
Ride or die.
From the day we arrive on the planet, and blinking step into